for quite a while. Anytime you talk to our Hall of Fame members, and when you think about being honored in this way, the honor to me is really secondary. It's nice because I tell people all the time, I don't know if getting inducted in any Hall of Fame is going to make you happy or sad or change your life or whatever. But the one thing that every time that I've been honored like this and happened this time again, my favorite part is to be able to remember back and the good times, the fun, the time here in Dallas that week in 1995, leading up to the 95 Cotton Bowl. It brings back in great memories and stories that you can tell and people you can reach back with. And so for more than anything, thank you so much to the entire Cotton Bowl team for inducting me, finding me, and I feel worthy. I do have some, a little bit more upset about a couple things I'd like to bring up. As an offensive lineman, one of the things we usually do, no respect. Then we go right again for you. I can't get any respect for you. This is no respect as an offensive lineman. And I've gotten used to it, but here this week, the last couple days, it's even done deeper. One, you guys sitting next to Bob Bullock, great player, but he's never been. If you know anything about college football, you know that you guys sitting there and hate each other. So having to match the gold dome like Bob makes it very difficult. Plus, he played defensive line. My goodness, just tipped me when I'm down. And then secondly, it was last night we were at the dinner. Let me say this before I say what I'm about to say. One thing, you guys know how to host people here in Texas, in Dallas. The top one knows how to take care of people. There's no doubt about that. This is one thing I find the advantage that my wife and I have. The highlight, one of the worst in my life I've ever seen. The Bradley's, I said, offensive line, I was talking to Rick about this, and said, well, that then they didn't look at the offensive line very much. It's always the quarterback and the guys making the tackles. Again, disrespect. I'm going to do that, I promise. I mean, I missed the ball, but I highlighted it, and I'm going to do it. I feel so good, you know, I don't put that guy in the whole thing again. But in all seriousness, it's a great honor. I love the game of football. I think it's the greatest sport ever played. It has done so much for me as an individual. I wouldn't be here today without the game of football. Obviously, I wouldn't have my wife without the game of football. I would have been at the University of Southern California playing major college football. I've got to play in the NFL. It is really, actually, 21 years ago today, I was drafted in the NFL as a second overall pick. Football has given me more than I've ever given to it. I'm so thankful for it. And the other thing I'd like to close is, I don't think any of us can get into our life by ourselves. And I want a lot of people to think. First and foremost, I did not make myself 6'8". I helped get there to 320 pounds, of course. But I thank my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, for making me, giving me, I let them know that I think my parents have dealt with countless hours and time to give me a football practice. All the great coaches I've had, that's some of the greatest coaches in my life, Sam McDonald, my high school coach, Larry Smith and John Robinson, our coaches at USC, Mike Berry, John Maxwell, Bob Pack, the offensive line coaches that I have. I mean, just amazing people. Taught me how to play the game, that allowed me to be here today. When I got there, my wife, and my daughter, who picks up, she was here at the conference, she was a cheerleader for USC, and so we got to kind of experience the top level together. And so I, what a life. I'm so thankful to the people in my life that allowed me to do what I do. And I had great memories of that week. And I thank you for bringing back. It was a great game for us. The Texas Tech game was probably the worst Saturday ever. Worst bowl game in history. 55-10 in the beginning. 34-0 half. And a couple, two things I remember about that game. Well, there's a number, but two things I'll mention. One is we come out after a great week. We talked about hosting a team. We were treated better than any bowl game we've ever been to. And it was outstanding. I remember coming out and down the old Cotton Bowl. I wish we played here, because I feel that the old Cotton Bowl might be the worst match that we played on, but hey, it was the Cotton Bowl, and it was awesome. We walked down the ramp, and all any Texas Tech fans here, throwing a bunch of tortilla guys. I'm like, you know, we're from California. What the heck are we doing? I thought we ate those things. They're throwing tortilla guys. That was the last time they threw tortilla. things happened after that. We were up 8-0 in the first quarter, 34 out of the half. And at halftime, John Robinson, our head coach, coming in and saying, "We're going to play one more series." And then you're done. We were winning so bad. We didn't break that. We still haven't stopped.